the debate tonight. 31 days after the Bulandshahr mob attack incident, key accused Yogesh Raj has finally been arrested. Now, the VHP and Bajrang Dal have hired nearly a dozen lawyers to defend Yogesh Raj.
विश्व हिंदू परिषद ने एक लीगल पैनल 10 वकीलों का घोषित किया है, तो 10 वकील उसके लिए अच्छी बेहतर लीगल टीम उसके साथ रहेगी, जो उसके लिए बेहतर होगा वो करेंगे।
31 people have been arrested till now, in which Yogesh Raj, Prashant Nutt, Kalua, Jitu Fauji, all of them have been arrested on charges of killing the inspector, but the rest have been arrested on charges of cost slaughtering.
जी, वीडियो देखा गया है, पहले भी लोगों ने देखा था, उसके बारे में भी पूछताछ की जा रही है। सारी चीज़ों, सारे तथ्य क्या हैं, कैसे है, जो भी आरोपी के द्वारा जो भी 161 का स्टेटमेंट है जो दिया जाएगा, उसको रिकॉर्ड किया जाएगा और माननीय न्यायालय के सामने उसको प्रस्तुत किया जाएगा।
योगेश राज वाज स्पॉटेड एट बुलंदशहर ऑन द डे ऑफ द मॉब वायलेंस, आफ्टर व्हिच ही एब्सकॉन्डेड एंड वेंट इनटू हाइडिंग। देन आफ्टर ही वाज नेम्ड इन द एफआईआर, ही मैनेज्ड टू रिलीज अ वीडियो क्लेमिंग हिज इनोसेंस। Earlier on Tuesday, the UP police arrested Kalua, who allegedly hit slain police officer Subodh Kumar Singh with an axe on his head. After that, the police inspector was allegedly shot by Prashant Nutt, who is already in custody. Mirror now asks, was there a larger conspiracy in the Bulandshahr case? Why is right-wing organization Bajrang Dal backing key accused Yogesh Raj? Let's debate.
Well, the police have put out a press release of the fact that they have arrested now key accused Yogesh Raj. But when we spoke with legal experts, there was a point of concern. Police have failed to register a case of conspiracy, and this could make a difference to what is proved and how strong the case is. And that's what we're going to discuss today. Joining me on the show, OP Mishra, spokesperson of the UP BJP, Ghanshyam Tiwari for Samajwadi Party, Aniket Nigam, he's a criminal lawyer, Kailash Vasudev, senior advocate with the Supreme Court, Dhanraj Vanjari, former ACP Mumbai, Atul Chandra, he's a senior journalist, and Kuldeep Rana, spokesperson for the Bajrang Dal. Gentlemen, I thank you for your time. Thank you for joining us on the show. Mr. Kailash Vasudev, I will start with you. My team has sent you documents that we have received today. You brought this up the last time we discussed the case, the fact that criminal conspiracy was left out of the list of charges. It remains omitted even today. Do you believe it will make a difference to this case?
Good evening. First things first, let me wish you well for the new year. More
Happy
reporting,
new year to
you too. More challenges, more fun.
Thank you.
Coming now to this particular case. See, you have, I mean, if you read the first information report, which I have before me, It says, "Namit uprokt vyaktiyon ke liye bhadkate rahe." Now, that is an indication that there was a planned move by the named accused for the purpose of instigating violence. To my mind, and I would think that most police officers would also say that this is a situation where you have a named group of people who have instigated violence, it is a conspiracy to do a certain act. Therefore, 120B should have come into the picture, because it becomes an action in concert for carrying out violence. The law provides that when the magistrate takes cognizance of the offence and he receives a charge sheet from the police, he can add additional charges in it. For example, now 120B is missing here. The magistrate at the point of time of taking cognizance can add 120B. The police should have added 120B at this stage itself, because then what happens is everybody is acting in concert or in a conspiracy. You cannot say there is one particular accused who's doing a particular thing or not doing a particular thing. In any event, from this FIR, they should have also said what were the actions attributed to the three gentlemen who have actually axed the police officer. If that was done, it would have been of greater assistance to the court, because they're relying on the video and they had the video before them. So therefore, 120B can be added by the magistrate. It's an omission by the police. Whether it is deliberate or negligent, that is for the magistrate to decide. But at these charges, including 120, the other whole host of charges which are there, which include sedition, etc., they should have included 120B, in my opinion. Whether it will weaken the case or no will be a matter which the magistrate will look into. But it would have been of greater help in bringing these people to book as a conspiratory group for the purposes of carrying out violent activities.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Vasudev. Mr. Atul Chandra is a senior journalist. Atul Chandra, the police has now finally arrested the main accused. We understand the Bajrang Dal has made statements to the press saying that they've already put together a team of 10 or 12 lawyers to make sure that Yogesh Raj is not sent to jail. What is your reaction to that?
See, it only shows that Bajrang Dal in Uttar Pradesh is getting out of control. And the sooner the government strikes at them, the better it will be for the society at large. After this Bulandshahr incident, we saw another incident in Hathras in which a police officer was threatened by a Bajrang Dal leader, saying that he was told that Bulandshahr will be repeated in Hathras if he didn't follow the diktat of that local leader. Now, the thing is that will they allow fair trial or will they try to browbeat the prosecution? That also is possible. It's not beyond these people. One thing which I'd like to add to the 120B part is that from the very first day, the Chief Minister and the police have been saying that there was a conspiracy. Now, if there was a conspiracy, why is that section missing? The effort should now be to unravel that conspiracy, because it is not just that a senior police officer was murdered. Also, some Muslims were framed. Yogesh Raj had named these Muslims in his FIR and they were found to be innocent.
Yes.
So, will an action be taken on those grounds against Yogesh Raj? Also, I am forgetting if the FIR contains section 295 and 153A. Instigating.
No, it doesn't.
If he was there instigating the mob, that also is a serious offense. But more importantly, coming back to your question, Bajrang Dal, like it was with Hindu Yuva Vahini at one point of time, is going berserk and it has to be checked, it has to be controlled right now, before it is too late.
OP Mishra for the Uttar Pradesh BJP. Mr. Mishra, you've just heard the statement made by Kailash Vasudev and Atul Chandra. They're both of the agreement that the Uttar Pradesh police has left out section 120B of conspiracy, and that will make the case more difficult to prove. Is the UP police going easy on the Bajrang Dal and its members?
Look, Ferry, this is not the case that UP police is going to be easy on these culprits. Culprits are always culprits, and government is not going to spare anybody who had their hands in the mob violence on last month in Bulandshahr. So, what Mr. Atul Chandra has told, I totally disagree that some Muslims have been framed. There are two cases have been lodged over there. One is mob. The first one is mob violence and second one is cow floater. Hmm. So there are two different cases and there are two different aspects. So police are probing, and now as of now 31 culprits have been taken into custody and the main accused have been now in police custody. So now police are probing the case and the truth will come out very soon. And the matter of defending the lawyers, because everybody has right to defend himself. Even a terrorist can be, a court can be opened for terrorist. Then how can you deny somebody to have the lawyers of his own choice, even 10 or 12 or whatever the numbers? So I don't think there is any things which he can't do to.
OP Mishra, हमें ये बताइए कि 120B register क्यों नहीं हुआ?
Hey, can I come in?
That is the merit of the case. Now police are probing the case, and if 21B is needed, then it can be included at any time.
Aniket Nigam, go ahead, please.
Pay.
No, if the,
from the beginning
if
and from the inception, when this case has, when this incident has taken place, it has been stated. It has been stated by everyone
time,
that this
Aniket
was a well orchestrated,
yes,
well planned act.
Hmm.
This seems to be a case where it was well orchestrated, well planned act, and this seems to be a case where there was meeting of minds between all these accused persons at the time of this incident. Now, when that is so, I fail to understand why in the first place the police have interestingly and intelligently invoked Section 149, which is Section 149 of the Indian Penal Code, which is unlawful assembly, unlawful. The police has invoked Section 149, which is unlawful assembly acting in prosecution of a common object.
Yes.
Now, when they say that there was a common object that was sought to be achieved by that unlawful assembly, I don't understand why the principles of conspiracy are not attracted to this case. This is a case where so many persons have killed a police officer in a brutal manner. He was lynched, he was assaulted, and what I'm being also told is that post-mortem report reveals not only a bullet injury, but also blunt trauma that was sustained by the deceased officer. Now, if this is a case where this officer was subjected to such trauma and cruelty, and the police have invoked the provisions of Section 149, which is prosecution, which is unlawful assembly, prosecuting their common object, why have they not invoked Section 120B so far? I understand that the FIR need not be an encyclopedia, but I would want to understand and know from our panelist who is representing the government of the day to state, to say on this panel whether in the remand report so far have they invoked the provisions of Section 120B. There have been several accused persons who have been arrested, who have been remanded to police custody and subsequently to judicial custody. It has almost been 30 days, more than 30 days from the date of this incident. Now, have they in the police remand reports invoked the provisions of Section 120B even by now, by this time?
Well, as of today, from what we understand from the police, they have not. What they have invoked are rioting with an armed and deadly weapon, unlawful assembly, sedition, voluntary causing hurt to a public servant while he's doing his duty, voluntarily causing grievous hurt to a public servant, assault, criminal force, wrongful restraint, and endangering life of public, attempt to murder, mischief causing damage, mischief causing fire and dacoity.
This means...
Yes.
This would mean that they are wanting to show that this is not an orchestrated act. This is not an act where there was meeting of minds. And they probably would want to show that this is a spontaneous reaction. Now, this is quite surprising. At one point in time, they say that the unlawful assembly was prosecuting a common object, which means that there was meeting of minds between those accused persons. And at the same time, they would not invoke the provisions of conspiracy.
Well, I want to ask Dhanraj Vanjari this question. As a former police officer, Mr. Vanjari, not having Section 120B, does that make it more difficult to prove this case or to prove that there was a conspiracy and these people conspired to kill the police officer in question?
As per my knowledge goes, Faiz, it is very simple and easy and will be more logical now to apply Section 120B, a criminal conspiracy. What happened if you invoke the Section 8 of Indian Evidence Act? Every behavior, previous and the subsequent conduct of accused, is admissible in the law as evidence. Now we have one panora here that 31 days have passed. Police, I am sure, will track his antecedents for those 31 days, hour to hour. That will create a chunk of evidence. Now, regards to his subsequent conduct and matching to the previous conduct, where he has particular behavior to his antecedents before the lynching of and murder of this police officer. Now, both these can be connected. I don't think in this country no one can stop from application of 120B, a criminal conspiracy in this case. Let's look at the pragmatic way to the police investigation. What has happened over here, in the FIR, they have taken unlawful assembly as a shield. If suppose there is something wrong being done by the police, those police officers would definitely be exposed in the court of law tomorrow, those who have taken this unlawful assembly as a shield. Because nowhere in the law it is said that if it is unlawful assembly, it cannot be criminal conspiracy. It can be criminal conspiracy. A biggest challenge before UP police is their senior boss, senior police officer has been killed. And if police will not justify their uniform, I don't think they will be justifying even their existence as human being on this globe. This is such a big challenge. I expect police to do a concrete detailed application, and before filing the charge sheet, they are under obligation to apply Section 120B, a criminal conspiracy in this case.
Mr. O.P. Mishra, one very senior advocate, one criminal lawyer, one senior police officer, one senior journalist have all said that the police has not used the right charges in this particular case. Why is the police going easy on Yogesh Raj?
Look, there's a. At first instance, there is a mob violence, and the spontaneous reaction was there for the people who had gathered at that place. Mm. So I don't think there's any
What is your proof, Mr. O.P. Mishra, that this was a spontaneous reaction? What is your proof that this was a spontaneous reaction? You used the word spontaneous. On what basis are you saying it's spontaneous?
No. Because the mob has been, the people have been gathered there to protest the. No, I am not justifying to remove that, but I have taken, the law will take its own course, and if it needed.
No, never mind, Mr. Mishra, when as a representative of the ruling party, that is very close to the Bajrang Dal, yes. If you yourself are using words like spontaneous, yeah. Then we can be sure of the fact that the law is not taking its own course, and that you are actually jumping to conclusions yourself. Now, on what basis have you reached a conclusion that this was a spontaneous gathering of people,
the mob,
instead of a conspiracy?
But how can I say there was criminal conspiracy was there? Of course,
you register a case of criminal conspiracy, you investigate it, and then you attempt to prove it. You don't do it the other way around. You've left it out of the charges. Why haven't you registered a case of criminal conspiracy and then investigated it? You've decided already that it was a spontaneous reaction. On what basis? I want to understand.
Needed,
on what basis have you, as spokesperson of the BJP,
needed,
decided it was a spontaneous reaction?
No. I'm the spokesperson of the BJP, not the government. Why they had excluded it 120B, they have to explain and they have to think. But what I have to say, that was a spontaneous reaction of the mob who had gathered over there, and now the things have been taken place that was not very appreciable. We had already condemned the thing, and police have taken the action, and now 31 people have been arrested, and the probe is on, and the truth will come very soon.
The truth will not come very soon, because for as long as you are sitting on national television using words like spontaneous, then the truth is very far away from being discovered. I want to take this back to Kailash Vasudev. Mr. Vasudev, a representative of the BJP in Uttar Pradesh uses the word spontaneous more than once. It has not been proven, Mr. Vasudev.
Look, I read out from the FIR. कुछ लोगों कोतवाल स्टैंड सपोर्ट के प्रति लेकिन कहा गया
मिस्टर वासुदेव प्लीज
सर बट यू डोंट से इन योर एफआईआर टू बी सेज उन्होंने आग्रह किया लोगों से इट इज योर एफआईआर इट सेज दैट दे वर इंस्टिगेटिंग द पीपल टू डू सो नाउ इफ यू आर सेइंग दिस इन योर एफआईआर देन हाउ डू यू से इट इज स्पॉन्टेनियस मिस्टर मिश्रा Please pick up the FIR if you have it before you.
It was definitely not spontaneous.
Somewhere in the middle, you will find exactly what the police have to say. It is definitely not spontaneous. It is something which the police says that they were organizing and they were asking people to take recourse to violence. I mean, see, if you're making a statement of fact on national television, see what the report says.
How can
then turn
they
around
have,
and say
no,
it's
no,
spontaneous?
No,
the police
how
say
can,
not spontaneous.
No, no, how can we say there is organized crime is there?
And if you're turning...
Because people have gathered to lodge the FIR for something
FIR
they had
system.
Found which should not have been there. So they are there to protest the thing. And they are not... there is not like that...
O.P. Mishra, Mr. Mishra, might I remind you, you are here to represent the BJP, not defend the accused. You seem to be defending the accused, Mr. Mishra.
No.
I have a simple position. If the police are saying something in their FIR, I'm holding it before you.
When everybody...
Why are you taking a position contrary to the police?
No, one at a time.
31 people have been...
Mr. Mishra, Mr. Kailash Vasudev has a question for you. If the police says in its FIR that there was a conspiracy, why are you taking a view that's contrary to the police?
He says... उपरोक्त व्यक्तियों उपरोक्त व्यक्ति हिंसा के लिए भड़काते रहे जिसमें इस भीड़ में समूह में नाउ देयरफॉर यू आर इन द स्टेटमेंट आई एम रीडिंग फ्रॉम योर एफआईआर सर वी आर नॉट इमेजिनिंग इट इफ दिस इज द पुलिस एफआईआर देन व्हाई आर यू ट्राइंग टू से इट्स एन स्पॉन्टेनियस एक्शन द पुलिस ऐसे भड़काते रहे फिर भड़काते रहे तो कहां हो गया आपका दिस स्पॉन्टेनियस एक्शन It's an unlawful assembly which is taken to rioting on being instigated. I mean, I'm holding it before you. Here. Read it. Then make your comments, sir. Please don't go around making comments which are contrary to recording. It is shameful. You are going to take a position? Take a position, by all means. What the courts will decide, they will decide. What the police have said, they have said. The police have made an error. They may have made an error. You may say there's some error. It may be negligence. It may be anything.
Of course.
Or not including a conspiracy allegation.
Of course, what I told.
If that is so, the court will take course.
Then now 31 culprits have been taken into custody.
And the main accused is also into custody. 120B. No. 1 second, Mr. Mishra. Mr. Mishra, I'm sorry I'm interrupting you. If this is the report, 120B should have come. How are you to turn around and say it is not supposed to be there? If this is the police FIR, it should have been there.
Yes.
That's what we are all feeling. And this is what has been felt on this program before. Don't please go around and make spontaneous statements. It is spontaneous, etc. It is not. It's an organized affair because the FIR says it started with a cow slaughter allegation made against people. Shuru shuru mein wo kehte hain. Ke Gorakshar ki ghatna ki suchna prapt hui thi.
Yeah, look, Mr. Bajpayee, Two FIR have been lodged over there.
So there are two FIRs.
One for cow violence.
Just a second, Mr. Mishra, this FIR is in retaliation to the first.
And one
this
against
is
the mob violence.
Of the first.
All right, Mr. Mishra, one second. So Mr. Mishra, one second. Let me bring in the rest of the panel.
Why people have gathered over there?
Ghanshyam Tiwari from the Samajwadi Party joins us as well.
Why
Mr. Tiwari, thank you for waiting very patiently.
Then you plan the violence.
All right, Ghanshyam Tiwari, please go ahead.
Well, I see the line that Mr. Mishra is taking.
Tiwari,
is the line that the chief
before you
has
send
taken.
To Mr. Mishra.
Sure.
One second. Forgive me, Ghanshyam Tiwari. One second, Mr. Vasudev.
I want to say one thing.
Yes.
I just want to say one thing. If the FIR starts that an instance of cow slaughter was noticed. Then this is good enough to say there was a conspiracy to cause violence because of the alleged incident of cow slaughter. Therefore, conspiracy comes in. Had there been no cow slaughter, there would have been nothing of this kind. So therefore, it is a situation which is created pursuant to
that
an FIR or an allegation
said.
Made in which the people have been discharged.
Absolutely.
Then,
so
you're right. Not only their conduct, they should, I think, be... I mean, prosecuted for the purposes of being in breach of their obligations as police officers.
Mischief in the very least on the part of the UP police.
Everywhere it is the same situation.
Yes. One second. Let me bring in Ghanshyam Tiwari, please. Ghanshyam Tiwari, go ahead.
UP police have...
Yes.
I'm sorry. Yes.
Well, I see a line that the Chief Minister took right from the moment this instance happened. The first approach was to sit back and relax and allow the events to unfold. Next was to prioritize the conspiracy around cow, the conspiracy angle that Bajrang Dal, BJP, VHP together have been speaking about, and make the death of the brave police officer a secondary subject. It was not even mentioned to start with. And then calling it accident at one go and political conspiracy at another. So clearly the Chief Minister is trying to set an example, though a wrong one. This is an instance that is going to repeat. Just today there are news coming about in Aligarh there's some Caracas and again something is building up. If the government wanted to set an example, they would have set an example in a way that anyone who wants to build a conspiracy, spontaneous or otherwise, anger or otherwise, wanted to build a conspiracy around this matter, the government would have methods and would use this case as an example to ensure that such conspiracies would not build up. But instead, the government has clearly sided at the Chief Minister level with those who want this script to repeat. And then the question would be with the police, that would police have the courage that Subodh Kumar Singh had to face that crowd that and face people like Yogesh Raj who were instigating the crowd? And the answer is we do not know. As a result, you have pictures emerging in Uttar Pradesh where cows are being logged in schools. When you bring out those cows, police transports them, they are getting attacked. The BJP government is coming up with schemes like 0.5% cow cess. So there is a complete mismanagement on this issue so that the propaganda can stay.
Right. I also want to bring in Kuldeep Rana of the Bajrang Dal. Mr. Rana, we understand the Bajrang Dal has got together a panel of 10 or 12 lawyers to defend Yogesh Raj. Why is that? Why are you defending Yogesh Raj?
बिल्कुल योगेश राज को बचाने के लिए एक तो कानूनी प्रक्रिया है अगर लॉयर्स को हम हायर करते हैं तो इसमें कुछ भी कानून का उल्लंघन नहीं है दूसरी बात यह है कि पुलिस ने भी जहां तक कहीं भी ऐसा नहीं आया कि योगेश राज ने हत्या की है और साथ में योगेश राज ने खुद भी अपने वीडियो में कहा कि मैं घटनास्थल पर मौजूद नहीं था तो एक आदमी को हत्या का दोषी और मुख्य साजिशकर्ता कैसे हम करार दे सकते हैं कि जो आदमी घटनास्थल पर है ही नहीं और सबूतों ने भी और पुलिस की कार्रवाई ने भी पुलिस की जांच ने भी ये बिल्कुल साफ किया है कि योगेश राज कहीं भी वहाँ जहाँ पर हत्या हुई है या वॉयलेंस हुआ है वहाँ पर अभी तक नहीं है जो कि मैं भी न्यूज़ के माध्यम से आपके चैनल के माध्यम से और मीडिया खबरों के माध्यम से भी अपडेट रहता हूँ उसमें कहीं भी ये नहीं लग रहा है कि योगेश राज ने उसमें कुछ किया है हाँ योगेश राज ने गायों के हत्यारों के खिलाफ FIR दर्ज कराई है और वो बिल्कुल सही कराई है क्योंकि उत्तर प्रदेश में गोवध निषेध है तो हमने योगेश राज ने कानून की मदद करने का प्रयास किया है चूँकि अनफॉर्चुनेटली वहाँ एक दुर्घटना हो गई वॉयलेंस हो गया जिसमें योगेश राज इन्वॉल्व उनका नाम आ रहा है FIR के अनुसार लेकिन योगेश राज तो कानून की मदद कर रहे हैं गोवध निषेध में जो गायों की हत्या करने
तो
वाले लोग
पुलिस ने उनका नाम FIR में क्यों दर्ज किया मिस्टर राणा पहला नाम तो नहीं था FIR में
उपद्रव होता है तो जी 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 मेरी बात सुनिए जब बहुत बड़ा उपद्रव वहां पर हुआ है तो उसमें जो संभावित नाम लगे उनमें उनका नाम भी लिया गया है
जो लेकिन आप कह रहे हैं कि योगेश राज तो पुलिस थाने के अंदर थे FIR दर्ज करते हुए गलत FIR वो भी जो नाम उन्होंने दर्ज करवाया था वो तो सारे निर्दोष थे तो फिर अगर वो पुलिस थाने के अंदर बैठे थे तो उनके खिलाफ FIR क्यों दर्ज हुआ
नहीं ये बात कुछ लोग जानते होंगे ना योगेश राज जानता है या एक दो
और अगर योगेश राज निर्दोष थे तो इतने दिन 30 दिन वो फरार क्यों थे
नहीं देखिए वो इसलिए क्योंकि इतना बड़ा वॉयलेंस हुआ है उसमें अननेसेसरी वो पिस ना जाए गेहूं के साथ घुन पिस जाता है तो वो उन्होंने कानूनी राय ली और अपने वकीलों के साथ वो अब कानून के प्रक्रिया में शामिल है और मैं समझता हूँ
ये आपके आपके बजरंग दल की वकील थे जो उन्होंने कहा था कि 30 दिन के लिए आप फरार हो जाओ ये कानूनी राय थी उनकी
नहीं मुझे इस बारे में जानकारी मुझे इस बारे में कोई जानकारी नहीं है कि वो फरार थे या मेरे से कोई संपर्क
फरार तो थे क्योंकि पुलिस से उनकी जानकारी नहीं थी कि वो कहाँ थे
नहीं प्लीज नहीं नहीं मुझसे सुनिए, मेरी बात सुनिए, मुझसे पूछकर वो ना तो फरार हुए ना वो छुपे, और जो भी उनको अच्छा लगा उन्होंने वो किया। और 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 देखिए पुलिस की अभी जो पुलिस ने अपनी कार्रवाई की है उसमें भी साफ नजर आ रहा है कि योगेश राज इनोसेंट है, इसीलिए उन पर बहुत अधिक शिकंजा नहीं कसा जा रहा है। चार पांच लोगों ने अपना जुर्म स्वीकार किया है और प्रशांत नट हैं और एक दो लोग और हैं, कलुआ है, उन लोगों से हथियार भी बरामद किए गए हैं जो पुलिस की जाँच के अनुसार है। क्या सही है
कुलदीप राणा, आपने कहा कि ये वकीलों की राय थी, ये लीगल ओपिनियन थी कि वो 30 दिन के लिए चुप रहे, ये आपको कैसे मालूम?
नहीं 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 प्लीज मैंने ये नहीं कहा, उन्होंने जो भी अपने लीगल प्रक्रिया में वो अपनी जो भी अपनी लीगल प्रक्रिया वो अपना रहे हैं वो उनका अधिकार है।
तो आप मुझे ये बताइए कुलदीप राणा, स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द बजरंग दल, की मेरठ में क्या हुआ? बजरंग दल के आपके एक कार्यकर्ता मेरठ में क्या कर रहे थे जब पुलिस पे हमला हुई थी दूसरी घटना में?
देखिए बजरंग दल के कार्यकर्ता कभी भी पुलिस पे हमला करने नहीं जाते, पहली बात। जहां भी बजरंग दल जाता है वहां कहीं ना कहीं कानून की मदद के हिसाब से जाता है।
तो आप लोग पुलिस पे हमला करके कानून की मदद कैसे कर रहे हैं? नहीं नहीं नहीं, समझाइए, मुझे समझ में दिक्कत हो रही है मुझे।
हम बजरंग दल क्यों करेगा पुलिस के साथ हमला? मेरी बात सुनिए, गाय का स्लॉटिंग हो रहा है वो एक अपराध है, हम उसके खिलाफ अपनी आवाज बुलंद करते हैं तो हम अपराध के खिलाफ आवाज बुलंद करते हैं और उसमें पुलिस हमारी मदद करती है और हम पुलिस की मदद करते हैं। लेकिन इसमें जैसा कि पहले भी प्रशासन की नजर में आ चुका है कि ये एक कॉन्स्पिरेसी है जिसमें साजिश की जा रही थी दंगा भड़काने की, तो बजरंग दल तो दंगा भड़काता नहीं है ना भड़काने में शामिल होता है। जो लोग गाय काट कर इजिप्ट में वहां हो रहा था, लाखों लोग मुस्लिम लोग वहां पर थे और हिंदू थे, हिंदुओं को भड़काया जा रहा था कि किसी तरीके से ये एक पत्थर कोई इजिप्मा के लोगों पर फेंक दे और बहुत बड़ा दंगा शुरू हो जाए।
तो आप मानते हैं मिस्टर कुलदीप राणा कि लोगों को भड़काया जा रहा था?
That was a conspiracy actually.
जी हाँ, लेकिन बजरंग दल नहीं भड़का रहा था।
तो फिर पुलिस ने कंस्पिरेसी रजिस्टर क्यों नहीं किया मिस्टर राणा, मिस्टर मिश्रा?
वही तो वो एक्चुअल जो एक्चुअल कॉन्स्पिरेंसी था वो एफआईआर में अवॉइड किया।
पुलिस करेगी, पुलिस को करना चाहिए, जो भी आवश्यक कार्रवाई है पुलिस अपने तथ्यों के आधार पर करेगी, ना तो मेरे कहने पर करेगी, ना घनश्याम जी के कहने पर करेगी, ना किसी और
किसी के कहने पर ही उन्होंने नहीं कराया।
साक्ष्य मिलेंगे
अनिकेत ने,
लेकिन पुलिस के एफआईआर में, पुलिस के एफआईआर में पुलिस ने कहा हुआ है कि दिस वॉज एन ऑर्केस्ट्रेटेड एक्ट where the mob had incited violence and pursuant to a common object they have committed the offense. I'll just read out three lines from the FIR which says, भीड़ उग्र हो गई, भीड़ के नामित उपरोक्त व्यक्ति हिंसा के लिए भड़काते रहे, जिसमें इस भीड़ के समूह में सम्मिलित सभी लोगों द्वारा उपरोक्त व्यक्तियों के नेतृत्व में एक राय होकर अवैध असलाहों, धारदार हथियारों एवं लाठी डंडों से जान से मारने की नीयत से हम पुलिस वालों पर हमला कर दिया। Now this is a case where there seems to be a well planned orchestrated act where the intent was to commit murder। अरे भाई साहब एफआईआर में अगर ये स्टेटमेंट है तो 302 के साथ 120 भी मतलब कॉन्स्पिरेसी क्यों नहीं लगाया? रिमांड रिपोर्ट्स
नहीं नहीं,
प्लीज प्लीज हियर मी आउट। आप पहले मेरी बात पूरी सुनिए और फिर आपको जो कहना है वो कहिए। पहली मेरी बात सुन लीजिए,
बिल्कुल मैंने आपकी बात,
आप मेरी बात सुन लीजिए। आपके एफआईआर में जब ये लिखा जाता है कि एक नियत से आप एक नियत से आरोपियों ने संगठित होकर ये 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 कार्य किया है, ये जुर्म किया है और पुलिस ने तब 120B कॉन्स्पिरेसी का सेक्शन नहीं लगाया है, एफआईआर में नहीं लगाया है, मैं समझ सकता हूं, चलो बेनिफिट ऑफ डाउट दे दिया। लेकिन 30 दिन हो गए रिमांड रिपोर्ट्स के बाद, रिमांड रिपोर्ट्स फाइल हो रहे हैं, उन रिमांड रिपोर्ट्स में क्या उन्होंने 120 का सेक्शन लगाया है 120B का? There was every available opportunity to the police to rectify their stand.
All right, Aniket, we begin Kailash Vasudev, please. Gentlemen, one second. Mr. Vasudev, go ahead.
But they have chosen not to do so.
See, just now Mr. Rana made a very frightening statement. He says, during the course of police investigations, notwithstanding the fact that the gentleman was arrested yesterday, the police said that there was nothing which, in his statement, I am quoting what he just said on a television channel, that there is no evidence, prima facie, against this gentleman. Do you know what we are trying to say? That the police has made a wrong statement in the FIR, is now backtracking? Is that not an indication of complacency and supports the view that 120B was deliberately omitted? Mr. Rana just said so. The police said prima facie, he was not involved. He was not there. I mean, how far can we go? In circumstances like this, where the police have very clearly said that the gentleman was there with others, is named and accused.
नहीं, अभी जैसा
अभी आपने कहा है सर कि पुलिस वाले कह रहे हैं कि जैसा कि कोई पुलिस दिख आपने अभी कहा है सर
अभी अभी आप कह रहे हो ना तभी तो उसको आराम राहत दी गई है क्योंकि एक एक इनोसेंट को क्यों पुलिस फंसाएगी
नहीं नहीं क्या आराम दिया गया है बताइए मुझे क्या आराम दिया गया
क्या क्या राहत
आप लोग कह रहे हैं ना 120 भी नहीं लगाई तो
नहीं लगाई
आप ही तो कह रहे 120 भी नहीं लगाई तो वो इसीलिए नहीं लगाई क्योंकि वो कॉन्स्पिरेसी में शामिल नहीं है
नहीं लगाई क्योंकि बदमाशी है नहीं लगाई क्योंकि उत्तर प्रदेश पुलिस मिसचिप कर रही है इसके साथ बदमाशी है
31
लगानी चाहिए थी
लोगों को गिरफ्तार किया जा चुका है नहीं नहीं 31 लोगों को गिरफ्तार किया जा चुका है और आप कह रहे हैं कि कुछ नहीं हुआ हाँ तो जो एविडेंट है उसी के आधार पर एक तरफ आप पुलिस की बात मानते हैं एक तरफ नहीं मानते पुलिस जो कार्रवाई कर रही है ठीक कर रही है
एक्यूज्ड ओनली हम ये नहीं कह रहे हैं हम ये कह रहे हैं कि पुलिस
एक्यूज्ड ओनली हाउ कैन वी हाउ कैन वी
वन एट अ टाइम प्लीज वन एट अ टाइम
इट्स नॉट अबाउट द नंबर ऑफ अरेस्ट
देखिए मुझे
इट इज अबाउट व्हिच सेक्शन
और इंटेंसिटी कानून पर भरोसा है बिकॉज़ मुझे पुलिस पर भरोसा है इसीलिए मैं कह रहा हूं कि मेरे जो साथी हैं मेरी बात सुनिए मैं इसीलिए कह रहा हूँ
हमें भी जो मेरे साथ है, जिनके ऊपर हमें भी पुलिस का आरोप है और इसी वजह से हम ये हाँ, चर्चा
तो,
कर रहे हैं
वही हम कह रहे हैं तो आप पुलिस को एडवाइस कीजिए जहां अगर कोई कमी हो रही हो तो वो पूरा करें हम बिल्कुल कोऑपरेट करने को तैयार हैं और 10-10, 12-12 वकील होना कोई बुरी बात नहीं है वो कानून की प्रक्रिया है कोर्ट कहता है आप अपना पक्ष रखिए हम अपना पक्ष रख रहे हैं और हम बिल्कुल भी नहीं कहेंगे कि हम अगर दोषी हैं तो हमें बख्श दो
हमारा ये नहीं है कि किसी के साथ 10 या 12 वकील खड़े हैं वो मुद्दा नहीं है
एक मिनट अतुल चंद्रा आई जस्ट वांट टू ब्रिंग टू योर नोटिस हाउ द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द बीजेपी एंड द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ द बजरंग दल सीम टू बी मेकिंग द सेम आर्ग्यूमेंट फॉर द अक्यूज्ड एट दिस पॉइंट
दैट्स व्हाट आई वांटेड टू पॉइंट आउट सी द effort of these two gentlemen as well as the police and the government seems to be to save Yogesh Raj and bring him out absolutely clean. Why? Because firstly, these people are saying that he was not a conspirator. He was not there. So that saves him in one way. The other point is that
it's police have
two persons have been named as alleged murderers.
Part of investigation.
Let him finish speaking,
no,
please.
Just one second. Two people have been arrested for allegedly killing the inspector.
Now police have now the investigation is on.
Dekhi, Mr. Mishra, on this channel we allow our co-panelists to finish speaking. Please allow Mr. Chandra to speak.
Mr. Mishra, you said that no Muslim was arrested. Two persons have been arrested for allegedly killing the inspector.
जो मुस्लिम के खिलाफ कोई कंस्पिरेंसी है No, you had
नहीं,
told
Mr. Mishra,
Chandra,
अगर आप सुनने के लिए तैयार नहीं है तो मुझे ऑडियो मॉडरेट करना पड़ेगा
नो आई सेड मिस्टर मिश्रा आई सेड दैट एट द बिहेस्ट ऑफ योगेश राज मुस्लिम टीनेजर्स वर पिक्ड अप बाय द पुलिस दे वर जेल्ड एंड दे वर इवेंचुअली फाउंड टू बी इनोसेंट So this was done at Yogesh Raj's behest.
After 20 days.
And you say that Yogesh Raj is not part of any conspiracy. Can you tell me who brought the carcasses there? What was the conspiracy to bring the carcasses there? Who has that conspiracy? And then name some innocent Muslims in that conspiracy that these people are responsible for killing cows. How can Yogesh Raj be so sure about it? So Yogesh Raj, the entire process is designed to protect Yogesh Raj. There is no conspiracy. He did not kill. He was not present. So apparently, the police are finding it difficult to tackle Bajrang Dal. They fear that there'll be a backlash if Yogesh Raj is sent to jail on conspiracy charges or for inciting the mob.
Kuldeep Rana, go ahead.
जी हाँ, मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि अभी इन्होंने कहा कि मुस्लिम जो एफआईआर हुए उनमें से कुछ लोग इनोसेंट है, ये लोग किसने इनोसेंट बनाए?
पुलिस ने।
कहीं ना कहीं पुलिस ने बातचीत की होगी, पुलिस ने पूछताछ की होगी, तो लेकिन पुलिस का अगर आप बिल्कुल अगर मुस्लिम है
टीवी पे बहस करने आ जाएंगे तो प्लीज अगर प्लीज रिसर्च करके आ जाइए। कुलदीप राणा जी, यूपी पुलिस ने उन लोगों को अरेस्ट किया और 20 दिन बाद उनको निर्दोष बोल के उनको छोड़ दिया। फिर बाद में 20 दिन बाद 20 दिन तक वो लोग लॉकअप में थे, फिर यूपी पुलिस ने बोला कि वो निर्दोष थे। अभी घनश्याम तिवारी
मैडम
प्लीज
देखिए देखिए बात बिल्कुल स्पष्ट है। योगेश राज हैज सेड दैट ही वाज एन आई विटनेस टू काउ स्लॉटर. Then the police discovered that after investigation that the carcass was two days old.
Yes.
So clearly, right from the moment this whole thing started unfolding, Yogesh Raj played a pivotal role. First in instigating, saying that he is a witness, naming people who were 10 and 12 year old, who eventually were proven innocent, and then instigating the entire mob to take a certain action. Even police has said, earlier report said that he and Kalua were instigating. So right from the moment this thing unfolded, you look at the response of VHP as an organization, Bajrang Dal as an organization, BJP as an organization, the local MPs and MLAs stood in support of Yogesh Raj. Not a single member of BJP has so far spoken against Yogesh Raj, neither a spokesperson, not a member within the government, nor a member who's elected member. So clearly the entire government is working to ensure that Bajrang Dal remains safe so that such instances can be repeated. You haven't seen a single campaign from Uttar Pradesh government. They have campaigned that protect cows, but they have not campaigned let us not turn Uttar Pradesh into Upadra Pradesh, let us not become mobs. They have not done any campaigns of the sort. So this is, as I said, it's a political propaganda that they want the state to keep boiling upon, and they do not want to set an example out of this case.
Well, it's also obvious because right now what Uttar Pradesh has is a menace of stray cattle going into people's fields, going into people's houses, eating their crop. They're being locked up in schools and public spaces. The Uttar Pradesh government has now tasked the police to look after cows, to feed them, pet them and take them for walks. Is this what the police is for? Because you've messed up the entire system by creating a fear around cows. This is what police is doing today. There's visual on your screen. This is, Mr. Dharaj Manjari, if you have a screen in front of you, this is what the Uttar Pradesh police is doing. They've been tasked with the job of collecting all the stray cattle and looking after them in police stations and feeding them and petting them before the 10th of January. There has been a mockery right now of law and order in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Every day a woman is raped. There are gang rapes. Four-year-old children are getting raped in the state of Uttar Pradesh. But that somehow is not in any way bringing out any sort of outrage from anybody, from the Bajrang Dal or from the police or from the government. But cows, for some reason. Cows are the most important thing in Uttar Pradesh. Now, Mr. Dharaj Manjari, after you've heard all of the arguments made by everyone on now, the panel, does it seem to you that the police is being like fair? This. In this
don't,
case.
Don't portray like this that everybody is raped in Uttar Pradesh.
Don't
portray like that.
Mr. Manjari, please.
I have my very straight views. Gentlemen, kindly listen to me. I have a very straight and simple view on the issue. The police department, since working under the thumb of Home Ministry, these politicians are just taking noose. This police is being misused. Not in UP, but everywhere. The percentage of misusing in UP is very high. Let me address this. I am talking with responsibility and on the national channel. Now, a big mockery of this issue is, as Mr. Chandra has said, that some cows, calves were brought and all this thing. This supports a theory of conspiracy. And very surprisingly, Bajrang Dal spokesman, Mr. Rana, is saying he perhaps doesn't know if tomorrow this clip of mirror now been played in the court, he is also supporting the theory of conspiracy. He is trying to defend the accused in such a lame fashion that he agrees by his own mouth saying they were gathering, we had come out there, hum sangatit hue the, hum ekatrit aaye the. These are all theories goes in support of conspiracy. And believe me, a day or tomorrow, police will have to apply 120B. Otherwise, there will be a big hue and cry. And I will not be surprised if investigation will go to the higher agency like NIA or CBI in this case.
हाँ, कुलदीप राणा जी बोलिए।
जैसा कि भाई साहब ने कहा, मैं कहना चाहता हूं कि हमारा कोई भी कहीं भी ऐसा कोई प्रोग्राम ही नहीं था कि हम इकट्ठा हुए या कॉन्स्पिरेसी की, अनफॉर्चुनेटली वहां लोग इकट्ठा हुए हैं और वो अनफॉर्चुनेटली दुर्घटना हुई है। हमारा कोई वहां पे प्रोग्राम नहीं था कि बजरंग दल वहां ऑलरेडी पहले से एग्जिस्ट था। और जो योगेश राज जैसा कि वो अपना डिफेंड कर रहे हैं, मेरी नहीं नहीं पलटने वाली बात नहीं है, जो हमारी अपनी थोट है, हम तो काव स्लॉटर के खिलाफ हमने कहा कि भाई इसे रोकिए और वो FIR दर्ज कराने थाने में गए, तो क्या थाने में जाना किसी बात की FIR दर्ज कराना कोई बुरी बात है? तो
नहीं, पुलिस वाले को मारना, पक्ष
रखने, पुलिस अपना कार्य कर रही है, पुलिस नहीं, नहीं हमारे संगठन ने नहीं किया है, दुर्घटना हम करते हैं ऐसा कुछ नहीं, नहीं हमारे संगठन का ऐसा कोई दुर्घटना हमारा कोई ऐसा ना है।
दिस इज अ मर्डर, ये खून है, यू हैव किल्ड, यू हैव किल्ड अ मैन इन यूनिफॉर्म।
नो नो सॉरी, हमारे हमारे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की कोई भी सोच नहीं है कि हम किसी भी पुलिस पे आता है या किसी पे भी आता
है। भाई साहब आप दुर्घटना,
ये एक मॉब भीड़ के द्वारा, नहीं नहीं
मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि आप किसी को भी इस घटना को दुर्घटना नहीं बोल सकते,
शामिल नहीं कर सकते,
ये अपराध है, ये मर्डर है।
इट्स अनफॉर्चुनेट, मैंने क्या कहा, इट्स अनफॉर्चुनेट एक्सीडेंट, क्योंकि अचानक हुआ, किसी को नहीं पता था।
नहीं नहीं कुलदीप राणा जी, आई विल नॉट अलाउ दिस, वन सेकंड मिस्टर राणा प्लीज स्टॉप, मिस्टर राणा प्लीज स्टॉप, प्लीज स्टॉप, नो नो एवरीवन स्टॉप फॉर अ सेकंड,
सर दिस इज अ मर्डर,
नो नो मिस्टर निकम, मिस्टर राणा प्लीज स्टॉप नाउ, आई हैव ऑन दिस चैनल इनवाइटेड द फैमिली of the deceased police officer, Senior Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh. The young boys have been on this channel, they have appealed for peace and justice. I will not allow you to sit here on national television and call that police officer's death an accident. That was not an accident. You want to know what happened to him, Mr. Rana? You want to know what happened to him? Someone with an axe chopped off his fingers. Then they attacked him and hacked him on the head with an axe and then took his own revolver and shot him in the head. His family, his 17-year-old boy, had to see his father in that state. How dare you? And I don't care what organization you come from. How dare you sit here and call this an accident? Kabhi hadsa mein kabhi hota hai aisa ki kisi ke haath kaata jata hai, kisi ke sar pe mara jata hai, unke sar pe goli chadai thi aur aap keh rahe ho ki hadsa hua tha, aap kaise keh sakte ho? Where is your sense of empathy?
Main maafi chahta hu yadi mere shabdon se, प्लीज प्लीज मुझे सुनिए, यदि मेरे शब्दों से किसी को दुख हुआ हो तो मैं माफी चाहता हूं, लेकिन वो जो लोग वहां हिंसा कर रहे थे उनमें से कितने लोग बजरंग दल के थे और कितने भीड़ का हिस्सा थे, ये बात जांच का विषय है। और जो लोग अभी तक की पुलिस रिपोर्ट में आए हैं, कलवा है या जीतू है, क्योंकि जीतू तो फौजी है, वो आर्मी पर्सन है, तो हमारे बजरंग दल का तो है नहीं, वो भी FIR में है, एक और हैं प्रशांत नट हैं, तो जो लोग बजरंग दल से
आपके
हैं,
लोग उस भीड़ में शामिल
थे, यदि हैं तो मैं कहना चाहता हूँ हमारे साथ भी अपराधी जैसे,
क्या आपके लोगों ने, आपके लोगों ने लोगों को उकसाया था उस दिन? Did they
नहीं, नहीं, हमारे लोग उकसाने का काम नहीं करते हैं।
तो अगर कंस्पिरेसी 120B
मैं कहना चाहूंगा कि हमारे लोगों ने ऐसा नहीं किया है,
उकसाने वालों को कभी जेल नहीं होगा। And that's the point we're making. Kuldeep Rana, thank you for joining us. I have to wrap this up here because we've run out of time, but it's simply boiling down to this. And there is a reason we're going to keep coming back to the Bulandshahr case on this channel, because I personally made a promise to the family of Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh. I said we will keep a track on this case, and it's not enough to just pick up the accused. It depends on how the police frame the case, how they register the FIR, how they register the charge sheet, and whether or not they're able to prove the crime. And whether or not it holds water otherwise, that main accused will go scot-free for lack of evidence in court. We're going to track every minute, little, needle-sized detail on this case. This was not an accident. It is offensive to Senior Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh, his wife and his children, to call this an accident. It's offensive to every single police officer in our country who puts on his uniform every day and risks his life to call this death an accident. It was murder. It was conspiracy. And the UP police must register conspiracy, because this is one of your own. And to not do it will show us that the UP police has perhaps been brought to its knees with political pressure, because to not defend your own, what do you have left to defend? Thanks for watching.